OG Weasel Urban Conversations, man. I'm back again with one of these prison bed chronicle stories, man. One time I'm in FCI Greenville, right? Now, if y'all remember, right, the story when the police got into it, when the police caught the Fed case that was attached to death row, Suge Knight. You know what I'm saying? He had some police that was on his payroll. I don't know if y'all looked at the documentary or whatever. Well, anyway, one of the police that got 15 years for bank robbery or something like that. Well, anyway, this motherfucker caught a Fed case and he came to FCI Greenville. What's his name? Craig? I can't remember the police name, but he was a police out of LA. You know what I'm saying? So when this motherfucker get here, right, he get to the compound. Even though he was a police, he wasn't no rat. He wasn't no snitch. You know what I'm saying? So his paperwork was good, no matter what profession you had, right? And he was a black guy, so let me reiterate that. So as the police dude catch the Fed case, he got 15 years, 12 to 15 years, something like that. I wasn't all the way in tune with it, but I was a part of this situation. That's why I'm talking to you about it. So when the police dude come to the jail, right? And once he hit the yard, all the 18th Street Mexicans, it was a gang of them. All the 18th Street Mexicans had a problem with this motherfucking police. You know what I'm saying? Him being from LA, them being from LA. So this was the issue with it. While he was a police in LA, he was free casing, giving these 18th Street Mexicans all these free cases, putting all these cases on these motherfucking Mexicans. You know what I'm saying? So when he get there, few of the Mexicans there that this motherfucker free case. So the Mexicans mad as a motherfucker about this shit. So when the administration get word that this dude David Craig or whatever his name is, when the administration got word that the Mexicans got an issue with him, they go to his cell. Go to his jail unit, the unit he was in, put handcuffs on him, and put him in a shoe. Special housing unit. That's the shoe. It's called the hole. So they lock him up and put him in the hole, right? And then in Greenville, FCI, Federal Correctional Institution, at the medium, they had a program set up called the Tough Man. If you go to the hole and you got some issues with a group of guys or some people drop a note on you talking about your life is in danger, they will give you a sheet of paper which would symbolize a tough man contract. The tough man contract, if you sign this tough man contract, that means you can come back to the yard and the jail not liable for anything that happened to you. You know what I'm saying? Because they got you out the way in a timely fashion. So when you ask for the tough man contract and you sign it, they'll let you back out on the yard. And anything that happened to you is on you. You know what I'm saying? They not liable for this. You know what I'm saying? So when the administration found out that this dude, Craig, had issues with the Mexicans, the Mexicans had issues with him. You know what I'm saying? Because with him being a police, a known police, there's a lot of dudes wasn't even fucking with him. You know what I'm saying? Just because he was a police. Nigga, you was a police on the streets, nigga. You know what I'm saying? So motherfuckers didn't respect it. But on his case, the nigga didn't tell on his case. So what the fuck? You can't run no nigga off the yard. Now, if you had an issue with him doing his job on the streets and y'all had confrontations like the Mexicans, then it'll be a different issue. You know what I'm saying? Because if a police came in and he was part of helping lock me up, you best believe that I'ma flex my motherfucking muscle on them. You know what I'm saying? That's just how that go in the prison system. So after dude David Craig or whatever his name is signed the motherfucking tough man, the police that was attached to Suge Knight, you know what I'm saying, that was security for Suge Knight and for Tupac and all of that, dude come to the compound. Then when the Mexicans, somebody dropped a note on him, the administration locked him up, then he signed a tough man. He goes back to the yard. Even though he come back to the yard, the Mexicans whispering. They mad. They this and that. They want to get him. But they cannot put their motherfucking hands on him. You know why? Because he motherfucking black. That's why. All else fails, nigga. They don't give a fuck, nigga. They could not put their motherfucking hands on him. So what they had to do is they had to come to all the blacks. They had to come to all the blacks, right? This fell on my desk. I only been in a couple years at this time, but I'm so solidified and so motherfucking thorough with this motherfucking prison shit. You know what I'm saying? My motherfucking prison status jumping up, jumping up, jumping up, because I'm a rider. I'm gonna push the motherfucking line. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of shit fell on my desk. You know what I'm saying? So when the Mexicans come to the blacks and say, man, this motherfucking dude, man, was in Cali. He was free casing us, putting guns on us, putting drugs on us, taking our money, man, beating us up, locking us up, man, and free casing us and this and that. You know what I'm saying? Say, man, you know, so the blacks was like, all right, he already a police. So the blacks was like, all right, then y'all go ahead and handle y'all business. You know what I'm saying? That was the honest to God truth. Y'all go ahead and handle y'all motherfucking business, because the blacks had already green lighted it. Like, fuck it. You know what I'm saying? We didn't trip off of it because somebody had already dropped notes on them and they had locked them up. So we ain't have to worry about us having no type of feelings about the Mexicans jumping and stomping him out or even stabbing him or killing him. So we ain't, that burden wasn't on us. But when he signed a tough man and came out on his own, that was on him. But even though when he came back out, the Mexicans couldn't put their fucking hands on him. So they had to come to the blacks and be like, man, hey, yo, dude put dope on us, put guns on us, got us time, got us sentenced, got us sent away, man. And this shit ain't right, man. You know what I'm saying? Dude, I think dude did a bank robbery or whatever, something like that or whatever, and came to the feds. So the blacks green lighted it, like, y'all go ahead, handle y'all business. I think they put a few stipulations on it, like, don't stab them or something. You know what I'm saying? And so dude used to always go to the weight pile and shit like that. So when dude go to the weight pile, going to work out and shit, I'm coming out the motherfucking, now I'm gonna tell you how organized this shit is. I'm coming outside to go work out. I make it to the fucking outside rec door to go into the gym. Man, the Mexicans chasing this motherfucking dude all around the motherfucking gym, stomping him. This nigga, man, it's about 20 Mexicans on this motherfucker beating his ass. He fighting back. They throwing down. So the blacks and a few blacks that didn't know about the motherfucking green light being put on him, some of the blacks wanted to get involved in it. But they had a multitude of black guys around like, nah, stay out of that. Stay out of that. You know what I'm saying? That's already been sanctioned. That's already been green lighted. Y'all stay out of that. You know what I'm saying? So when they go to beat the motherfucking black dude ass in this motherfucker, they going to beat his motherfucking ass. They beating his ass all through the soccer net. You know what I'm saying? They was out there playing soccer, so I guess he come out there to work out, and they was just like, fuck it. So we got a Mexican guard, man, that worked in FCI Greenville, which the Mexicans was close. Even though that these motherfuckers, one a guard and the rest of them inmates and convicts, Nigga, they was still in cahoots because that Spanish motherfucking pride is something else. And I just wanted to let y'all know this. You know what I'm saying? When I come through the door and they fighting a dude and I know what they doing because I already got the heads up that they was going to smash the gas on the dude. So I just get out the way, let them handle their business doing all of that shit, right? They kicking his ass all through the soccer net. You know what I'm saying? So when they doing that, I hear the motherfucking guard, the motherfucking Spanish rec officer, say something in Spanish to the rest of the Spanish guys, like, I'm finna hit the deuces. Y'all wrap that shit up. You know what I'm saying? He told him something in Spanish, like, all right, that's enough. You know what I'm saying? So when the dude said something to them in Spanish, they look up and kept on beating his ass. And when the Spanish dude said something, they let up off of him, and the dude got on out of there. And the guards came, lieutenant them came, locked dude up. I ain't see no more behind that. I think the dude's name David Mack or something like that. But the Mexicans beat his motherfucking ass in FCI Greenville. You know what I'm saying? And that's all I knew about that situation, man. That was just one of them. One of the motherfucking horrific stories that can happen to you in the feds, man. You know what I'm saying? So you got to be careful of what you're doing, no matter what profession you in. Because if you land in that motherfucking federal system and you ain't got people fucked up, that's what's going to happen to you, man. If you like what I'm doing, man, hit that like button, like and subscribe, man. Fed Prison Chronicles, man.